Hey everyone, John Enner here from School of Trade. Today we're going to be taking a look at a short trade here on crude oil, setting up a nice opportunity for a move down. There we go. So looking for a short, 3062 is the entry short. The stop is going to be nice and small just above this high. And essentially what we're looking for is this upward rising or ascending wedge, if you will, to break down. We have a nice little signal candle right here to tell us that we possibly do have sellers' interest. Now we just need to see the drive low. So initially, I'm going to be looking for my first target right here at support at 38. That's going to be my first target, taking two contracts off there. After that, the next area that we're going to be looking for support is the last time that we saw the buyers come into the market and pause, right? We had this huge smack higher, and we got a little bit stuck right here. We can see all the wicks on the highs there. So this was the decision point that had to take place. So because of that, I want to make sure to take some profit off at that location as well. So our final target there at 30.14 to get that last portion. Now, the first target from our entry point to the first target, we're looking at a 23 tick. After that, we're looking for that final target a little bit lower at 48 ticks. So we have plenty of downside room, especially considering that our stop is 8 ticks. So lots of really strong movement so far this morning. We had a huge bull move up. And the only reason I'm even considering going short right now is because I'm expecting a deeper correction back to that earlier decision point before the buyers jump back in. All of the buyers that are already in this move, maybe they were in earlier this morning and they bought down here, or you know, maybe they bought that pullback, or maybe they got in here at around the decision point and, you know, slowly added on the way up. They don't want to buy way up here. This is way too high now. Instead, they're going to be looking for the best or optimal price to get in at, and it's not up here, right? They're going to be looking for a nice deep pullback and then buy that pullback to go right back up to the highs. But until we get that pullback, I'm expecting some selling pressure. We have the buyers who've been riding this move up. They're going to be taking profit. You have sellers like myself watching this ascending wedge break down, knowing that there's a good likelihood that we take some profit down from the buyers and then we look to turn back around. So I'm not looking for a huge run on this. I'm only looking to hang on to this until the buyers want to come back in again, and I'm anticipating that around 14 or so. So once we see that move down, you can see an immediate reaction. We're already coming into our first target here. We tested it, no fill as of right now. It looks like a lot of people had the same opinion as us. 30.38 is that first target. We'll see if we can get that filled. Since we did tap our target but didn't get it filled, I want to lock my stop in a little bit tighter here. I'm only floating negative one until this one gets filled. Once it gets filled, if we get filled, we're looking for a breakdown to the next area at 30.14. So far so good. Sellers coming in very, very strongly. Now it's just a matter of, do they want to continue? And there we get that fill. Let's set the stop to one. And we'll go to break even. And actually, I'm going to leave the stop where it is at negative one. That gives it room above this candle's high. So giving it as much room as possible, looking for more continuation to the downside. We got the target filled at 38. Now we're looking for them to push down, if the sellers still control this a little bit, down to that 14 area before we start seeing potential options for buying again. So back in a little bit and see if we can get that drive lower. Seeing the seller still in the driving seat here, we've come one tick away from the target now, so let's lock the stop in nice and tight here. Now, really, we're just looking for that final oomph, that last little bit that the sellers have here. This is an area where I anticipate a lot of buyers to begin scaling into a move, looking for a move back up to the highs. So I do want to make sure that if this starts looking weak and starts going against us, that we just close the trade. We're playing with our target. Now we just need to see them actually give us a fill. We've come one tick away. The stop is nice and close. We're right around that area. We just need to see them physically push down. This is exactly what we were looking for. We had an ascending wedge rising its way higher. We broke down with a beautiful bear bar to kick the move off. And everyone, I believe, you know, from the looks of it, kind of followed suit and just dumped this thing right back to the lows. Now, this low move, again, I'm not anticipating this going all the way down to the low of day. That's not very probable. This was the last place that the buyers were seen before they paused for a little bit, right? We had that initial big old spike up. They paused for a little while, and then they continued back up. Now we're coming back to revisit that area, and that sort of visitation of that location again really kind of drives the point home to the buyers of, we're here again, right? Do you want to buy again? Do you want to defend this area, or are you going to break down, and are the sellers going to take over back to the low a day? Either scenario right now is on the table, but ultimately, because of this strong, strong move up we've seen so far this morning, I am anticipating the buyers taking this back up to the highs. Obviously, leaving a buy order right at 14, looking to scale in for longs, it's probably not the best way to do it. You want to wait for a little more confirmation than that, but this is the area where it's believed that they start coming back in again. So, looking for that fill at 14. If this candle closes relatively weak, we may just get out if it doesn't fill us here, and that's just to kind of play it a little bit safer. Our stop is already locked in nice and close, so we do have sort of the benefit of the doubt where we can give them a little more time here to see if they can get that fill. But you can see they're trying. They've come one tick away. Stops at 33. If it does whip back up and stop us out, we still put away a 28 tick target on that stop. So it's exactly what we need. Just need to give it a little bit more time and see if they can drive lower to get that target. All right, sellers looking like they're going to make another attempt at it. If they can't fill it on this candle, we'll take an early exit. Just because we've come one tick away, I really don't want to risk anything else. And if we double bottom, a little bit of a micro double bottom on this low at 15, the stop will get a little bit tighter as well. Just to prevent a situation where it comes down, on a faster time frame, maybe a 1 minute chart or something like that, you get a double bottom and then it ricochets and goes firing all the way back up. We don't want that to happen. This is a known area where buyers are expected to come in. So we need to be a little bit more aggressive on getting this target filled. So I do want to see them fill it on this candle. If they're not able to, we'll just take an early exit. So they got about a minute left on this candle. Let's see if they can kind of finish the job. Oh, and there we go. Beautiful. So they got that move down. They finished it, and now we got our target filled. Now, it's not to say that it's not going to slide through this, right? But this is an area that we're looking for buyers to come back in. So if we see respect here, looking to jump back into the long side and ride that move back up to the highs. But outside of that, beautiful move down. Overall, we bagged some just a gorgeous move down on only three contracts, still pulled in 96 ticks on the trade. So $960 on the trade for me. You might be able to hold it for a little bit more, but I really wouldn't want to try to hold through potential buying pressure here. So that's going to do it for me. If you have any questions about it, feel free to send an email to School of Trade. Don't forget to check out our trial at schooloftrade.com. And as always, we'll catch you next time.